PilotFish is a leader in integration engine solutions with customers in virtually every area of healthcare. Integrate faster and easier using PilotFish's exclusive graphical automated interface assembly line. PilotFish provides its customers with the freedom to connect and exchange data with disparate systems, applications, databases, devices, and equipment everywhere. PilotFish also provides the freedom and cost advantages of being operating system, platform, and database agnostic, and offers the flexibility to be deployed on-site or in the cloud. PilotFish software has been designed to support handling the nuances of any industry's information exchange, and with it, the semantics of its data and standards. PilotFish offers comprehensive support specifically for HL7 messages, all versions including 2.x, 3.x, and FHIR, and EDI X12 transactions. Specifically for those standards, PilotFish offers features and capabilities that make users far more productive and interfaces much easier to implement and maintain. PilotFish provides out-of-the-box support for virtually every other data format you might encounter too. You can accept data as Excel spreadsheets, PDFs, Word documents, email attachments, JSON, flat files, CSVs, and much more. Users can parse any format from any source too, including APIs, XML, web services, cloud applications, portals, and others. When it comes to connecting systems, PilotFish provides dozens of built-in connectors. If you need support for a connectivity protocol that is not included, users can add it in using our Open API or .NET Bridge. The PilotFish EI console is the integrated development environment where interfaces are configured following a graphical, automated interface assembly line. No coding or scripting is required. With this unique approach, PilotFish has revolutionized how data integration is done. They made it so easy that non-developers and business analysts can now do up to 89% of interface development and management. The PilotFish assembly line consists of 7 stages. The process starts by configuring your source and target systems. You label your source for easy reference later. In the source system stage, users can select from a library of built-in icons or load in their own. Add as many sources as you like in the same manner. In the target stage, users can select an icon and label it as well. You can also add as many target systems as you like. Now, let's take a look how the assembly line works. The listener stage is where you establish connectivity by selecting from a drop-down of dozens of built-in connectors. To make it easy, each has its own pre-configured panel with commonly used default settings. At the listener stage is where users have the ability to add processors. Processors can perform operations that affect the incoming data stream. PilotFish includes over 100 processors ranging from A to Z, anything from asymmetric decryption to zip decompression. Processors can be laid in any order, and again, you can easily add your own. The next stage is the source transform. Here the data needs to be converted into a common representation of that data so that when it reaches the next stage, the routing stage, all of the data is in the same format. This process happens in 2 steps. First, the data needs to be parsed so that it can be converted into XML. That is, if it's not in an XML format already. PilotFish's transformation module allows you to easily convert a variety of non-XML formats. These transformation modules are set up through a simple graphical configuration process. The transformation modules include CSV, delimited and fixed width files, Microsoft Excel, EDI including ANSI X12, and other HIPAA formats like HL7, and JSON too. The second step of the transformation process is where you perform the logical mapping. This is always an XML to XML transformation, represented as XSLT, and is done in the EI console's data mapping component. PilotFish has revolutionized data mapping with its exclusive 3-pane design and graphical drag-and-drop mapper. The source is represented on the left, the target is on the right. The middle pane is where you configure the relationship between the two via drag-and-drop mappings and additional logic. Unlike line drawing tools, which quickly become illegible with complex mappings, the PilotFish data mapper allows users to easily view and navigate through the mapping by just scrolling up or down in the center pane. By simply dragging and dropping, even business analysts can create complex mappings in minutes. They are fully reusable for huge productivity gains too. To use the data mapper, the source and target data formats are built using the Format Builder dialog. Various types of metadata, such as the HL7 data dictionary, can be directly imported, as can X12 table data and schemas. Additionally, the FHIR reader can take extension schemas through the FHIR standard, which is already built in. Sample files can be used too to provide an accurate picture of what a system may actually produce or consume. Note, when using HL7 and EDI X12 data, the friendly name option can be applied to the elements. This makes it easier to determine what fields are what. In this example, HL7 was loaded as a source, and a simple XML sample file was used as a target. Dragging and dropping these fields together in the center panel creates the one-to-one map. Above the three panels, a palette of XSLT functions and structures allows for conditional logic, looping logic, data manipulation, and much more, all without any custom or proprietary scripting. The mapping is created in XSLT, a W3C compliant language with a worldwide user base. In the PilotFish data mapper, users can work in code or graphical view in real time and swap back and forth between the two. After you have configured the sorts transformation stage, you move on to the route stage. Here users can add routing rules. You can send to all targets or layer XPath expressions to route transactions. You can also add transaction monitoring to set up email alerts, error route triggers, and SNMP traps. In the target transform stage, you can perform transformations on your data to match what the receiving system requires. As with the source transform stage, you can select from built-in transformation modules to instantly read in your data, or use the EI console's data mapper to map your data to the target format. Next is the transport stage. In the transport stage, like the listener stage, a configuration panel opens with a drop-down menu of over 36 built-in transport adapters. Among them, database SQL transport, directory, email, FTP, SFTP, HL7 LLP, and RabbitMQ. The user need only select and configure the appropriate transport for all their target systems. Once you have configured the interface, you can graphically test it end-to-end in the EI console's testing mode. In testing mode, you can start and stop your test at any stage and view the output of any stage. In testing mode, you're alerted to errors that you can work iteratively until your interface is fully tested and ready for deployment. Once you have fully tested your interface, the EI console for healthcare makes deployment easy too. With the PilotFish EI console, configurations are just files on the file system. To copy files, you simply navigate to the root directory chosen for these configurations and copy the files over to the other server. Use the EI console's built-in drag-and-drop feature, or you can deploy your interfaces through the EI dashboard, PilotFish's web-based application for operational reporting and management of your interfaces. Take a free test drive and download our free 90-day trial, or call us to learn more.